My name is Julie Champion. I'm a chemical engineer by training, both from my bachelor's degree, which I did at the University of Michigan, which is where I grew up, and then I went to California, to the University of California, Santa Barbara, where I got my PhD, and then stayed in California at Caltech for my postdoc. So I've been moving around the country, and now I'm here in Atlanta. In my lab, we work on what I call therapeutic materials. So what it really means is that we are working with drugs, but instead of working with kind of traditional drugs, we work with proteins that could be used as drugs. And what we do is we take those proteins that could be a drug by themselves, but we create materials out of those proteins so that they have the right delivery property, so that we can actually get the drug to go where we want in the body, as opposed to, you know, if you just inject a drug, it goes everywhere. And so since proteins are very sensitive drugs, we need to protect them and get them to only go where they need to go, to the diseased tissue. So we take the protein and form it into nanoparticles or fibers or films or gels, depending on where in the body it needs to go. And so we have this concept of a therapeutic material, where the protein is both the drug and the material that helps to deliver it and protect it where it goes in the body. What we have here, this is an incubator shaker. And so in these tubes, sometimes we actually have really large flasks. But right now we just have some small tubes in here. And what's happening in here is bacteria are growing. And the bacteria need, it's warm in there. They need that warm air, but they also need the agitation. And the bacteria are making the proteins for us that we use for these therapeutic materials. So we give the gene for the protein that we're working with to the bacteria, and then the bacteria will make that protein for us. And so in order for them to express and make this protein, they need that constant agitation and warm environment. And the gel imager here, this actually focuses, this is how we image the DNA that we give to the bacteria before we give it to them. So often we can't just buy the DNA sequence for a particular gene that we're looking for. We have to synthesize it ourselves. And so this is how we image the DNA that we're synthesizing to make sure it's the right size, which is indicative that it's the right sequence, which we have to confirm later on. But this is how we get that first check that it's the right size. So there's a good chance that it might be the right sequence. It's really easy to explain to someone, you know, who knows someone in their family who has had chemotherapy for cancer, right? The chemotherapy makes their hair fall out and they are nauseous and their white blood cell count goes down. So they get often can get very ill. And so they see that in their family member. But if I describe to you that what we're working on is a new way to deliver drugs so that they only go to the diseased tissue. So for example, for cancer, so the drug only kills the cancer cells and it doesn't kill your hair follicles and the lining of your stomach and your white blood cells. People can really relate to that. And they also, I think, are surprised that chemical engineers do that, because I think they don't realize that we can work in the health field and that we can try to make life, you know, better for people through medicine.